गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर फर्दर, चैप्टर 9 कंबशन एंड फ्लेम विद द टॉपिक टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन. व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन? सी, देयर आर बेसिकली फोर टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन: रैपिड कंबशन, स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन, कंप्लीट कंबशन, इनकम्प्लीट कंबशन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस हैव discussion in regard with rapid combustion. What is rapid combustion? Rapid means fast, quick. So it is a kind of combustion in which substance catch fire or burn rapidly, quickly, fastly in the presence of oxygen. Many a times rapid combustion result in fire. And extremely rapid combustion is known as explosion. So, rapid combustion is a combustion in which a substance catches fire or burns fastly, quickly, rapidly in the presence of oxygen to produce heat and light. Okay, so this is rapid combustion, and already I told you many a times it can result in fires, huge fires. So we have to take great care while dealing with rapid combustion. And an extremely rapid combustion is known as explosion. For example, LPG, CNG, these are inflammable substances which catch fire or start burning in the presence of oxygen at a very low temperature, at a very low ignition temperature, fastly, rapidly. So they undergo rapid combustion. Now, if we talk about spontaneous combustion, spontaneous means on its own. Means in this kind of combustion, substances catch fire or burn easily in the presence of oxygen on their own without the application of heat from external source. Means in this kind of combustion, we need not to provide or supply heat from the external source to the substance. It catches fire or burns easily in the presence of oxygen on its own without the application of heat from the external source, known as spontaneous combustion. For example, sodium is a very reactive metal. When we keep sodium outside in air, then what happens? When that sodium is exposed to the air, then being very reactive, sodium reacts with moisture, means water present in air, very vigorously, fastly to produce sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas, and an enormous amount of heat is also produced. Hydrogen is an inflammable substance. Even I would say it is a highly inflammable substance which catches fire or burns rapidly at a very low temperature. So what happens? This hydrogen gains this heat. And in this heat, it catches fire. It burns vigorously, rapidly on its own, known as spontaneous combustion. That is why sodium is kept immersed in kerosene so that it cannot come in contact with the moisture or water present in air and does not catch fire. Phosphorus is also a reactive non-metal. Okay, it when reacts with air or oxygen, it catches fire on its own. So if you keep phosphorus in open environment, then vigorously it reacts with oxygen present in air to form phosphorus pentoxide, which catches fire vigorously, spontaneously on its own. So we are not providing heat to the phosphorus to get reacted with oxygen, to get burnt in the presence of oxygen. We are not providing any heat from the external source to the phosphorus. We have just kept it open in the surrounding, and on its own it reacts with oxygen present in air. It burns in the oxygen rapidly, spontaneously to form its oxide and catches fire. That is why phosphorus is kept in water. It is stored in water because phosphorus does not react with water. So to prevent its contact with air or oxygen, it is stored in water. Now next, complete combustion. What do you mean by complete combustion? As the title suggests, in this kind of combustion, a fuel or a substance is burnt in the sufficient supply of oxygen, so it results in complete combustion. Because when a substance gets sufficient supply of oxygen, sufficient amount of oxygen, then it burns completely, known as complete combustion. So complete combustion is a kind of combustion in which a substance burns in the sufficient supply of oxygen. That is why it burns completely, known as complete combustion. Okay, for example, methane. Methane is a gas which is present in biogas, CNG. So this is an important fuel which we use in biogas, CNG. It is the important component or constituent of these fuels like biogas and CNG. When this methane gets sufficient supply of oxygen, then it burns completely in the sufficient supply of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water and energy, known as complete combustion. In complete combustion, fuel or a substance burns completely in the presence of sufficient supply of oxygen. So it does not produce any unburnt carbon particles. That is why it does not produce any smoke or soot. Smoke or soot consist of unburnt carbon particle, which it does not produce. Instead, it produces a clean blue flame. So methane, which is an important constituent of biogas and CNG, undergoes complete combustion when it gets sufficient supply of oxygen. You must have seen that LPG, which you use for cooking, that also undergoes complete combustion in the sufficient supply of oxygen. Okay? To produce carbon dioxide, water and energy. Now, let me tell you one thing. Most of the fuels like LPG, CNG, petrol, diesel, these are made up of hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons means they are made up of compounds which have hydrogen and carbon. So most of the fuels that we use like petrol, diesel, CNG, LPG, biogas, all are made up of hydrocarbons. hydrocarbons are the compounds made up of hydrogen and carbon. So we can conclude that most of the fuels are made up of hydrogen and carbon. So when they go for complete combustion, they produce carbon dioxide, water, along with the release of energy. Now, incomplete combustion. Incomplete combustion, as the title suggests, in this kind of combustion, a substance or fuel does not burn completely. Why? Because that substance or fuel does not get sufficient supply of oxygen. So, in the insufficient supply of oxygen, that substance or fuel burns incompletely, known as incomplete combustion. For example, same methane gas CH4, when it does not get sufficient supply of oxygen, instead it gets insufficient supply of oxygen, less oxygen, then it burns incompletely to produce carbon monoxide in place of carbon dioxide, along with water and energy. So, when a substance or fuel undergoes incomplete combustion, then it burns in the insufficient supply of oxygen to produce carbon monoxide, water, and energy. Along with this, unburnt carbon particles are also released, which form smoke or soot. When this soot is released out of the fuel, then it glows in the flame of the fuel and produces a yellow flame. So we can conclude that due to incomplete combustion of a fuel or substance, a yellow sooty flame is produced. For example, you must have seen that when gas inlets or gas holes are blocked due to dirt or insects or food particles, at that time LPG does not get sufficient supply of oxygen. So that LPG burns in the presence of insufficient supply of oxygen. As a result, carbon monoxide, water, and energy are produced. Along with these substances, a yellow sooty flame is also produced. At that time, blue flame is not produced by LPG on combustion. Instead, it produces yellow sooty flame. Whenever you see a yellow sooty flame coming out of your LPG stove, then remember one thing, that incomplete combustion of LPG is taking place. Why? Because LPG is not getting sufficient supply of oxygen. It is getting insufficient supply of oxygen due to the blockage of gas inlets by dirt, insects, food particles. So you need to adjust them, you need to clean them. Means you need to adjust or clean gas inlets and remove all the blockages present in gas inlets. In this way, you can provide sufficient supply of oxygen to the LPG, and then LPG will burn completely in the presence of sufficient supply of oxygen. It has three advantages. What are three advantages of complete combustion? First, fuel will not be wasted because it will burn in the presence of sufficient supply of oxygen, so it will burn completely, so your fuel will not be wasted. Second, more amount of energy, heat energy, is produced in complete combustion as compared to that of incomplete combustion. So more energy will be produced due to complete combustion, which helps you to cook your food easily, fastly. Third point, no smoke and soot will be produced. So when you will keep your container on that gas stove, that LPG will burn completely in the presence of sufficient supply of oxygen. So complete combustion of LPG will take place. As a result, clean blue flame will be produced. No sooty yellow flame will be produced. No unburned carbon particles will be produced. So at the bottom or base of the container, no carbon particles will be deposited. So you will not see any black layer or sooty layer on the bottom or base of the container, and they will not be blackened. So these are the various advantages of complete combustion. This is all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.